Hey there, coyotes.
Welcome back to another exciting week of CEMS TV.
We've got a great show lined up for you today, with stories on some delicious burgers from Luya's Burgers and a story about a local bakery. We'll also be taking a look at Cottages on Roosevelt, a Christmas-themed coyote camp and a North Carolina helicopter tour.
And to top it all off, we've got a special feature on Yosemite National Park. We also have some announcements to make during the show. I'm Piper.
And I'm Elizabeth.
And this is CEMS TV.
Hey Piper, do you like burgers?
Yes, of course.
Great, because Connor, Quinn, and Miles recently went to Muya's Burgers to see what it's all about. Let's check it out.
Hey coyotes, today we checked out Muya Burger in Carlsbad.
So I believe I wasn't here when the crew started, but I think Muya opened first about last year in March.
The restaurant also includes various cool paintings along the walls. We couldn't figure out what to order, so we asked a local employee.
The most popular item on the menu, that would probably be the Muya cheeseburger, or even the double cheeseburger, probably. It's just a classic cheeseburger. So.
Additionally, the restaurant's menu includes various other foods. This includes hot dogs, fries, shakes, and various other appetizers. They even include online devices to skip the line and order ahead of time. This is Connor, Quinn, and Miles, moo-yawing it back to the anchors.
Whoa, those burgers look delicious. I'm getting hungry just thinking about it.
Hey Piper, what's your favorite part about winter?
The music, why do you ask?
Because some of our broadcasting students went around asking what everyone's favorite Christmas songs were.
Great, let's see what it's all about.
That was great.
Yeah, I have to agree.
Wow, speaking about food, Sahar and Sammy Skinner went to go check out a restaurant in the village called Cottages on Roosevelt Feature.
Let's check it out.
Hey, coyotes. Today, me and Sammy Skinner went over to the village to visit the Cottages on Roosevelt. This unique location is located on 2956 Roosevelt Street and includes four different popular eateries. Today, we got to take an inside look at two of them, Revolution Roasters and Stella Jean's. Revo is known for their popular beverages, but also serves food from 7 a.m. to 2 p.m. Everything is made in-house and fresh, and is locally sourced. They also sell their granola and coffee beans, along with all their merch like cups, hats, and streetwear.
Some history about the company. When we first opened, it was about 8 years ago, and that was at our other location down the road in Oceanside. So it's about 5 minutes away, and there's that one that's been open for 8 years, and then this one actually just opened a couple months ago. Our most popular item on the menu is probably either our lavender honey latte or our vanilla latte. Something interesting is we make all of our own syrups in-house, so a lot of people really prefer like our vanilla over a lot of other places because of how it's made with the real vanilla beans in it. My favorite thing about working here is for sure the coworkers and just community around me. It's a very uplifting environment, and it's a very, like, almost like a family. Everyone's so tight-knit, and everyone is just very encouraging, and it's a really great environment to have.
Stella Jean's is also one of the cottage's most popular spots. They're famous for their assortment of unique ice cream flavors and their special seasonal flavors, which you can either get in a cone or in a pre-packaged pint. Not to mention their 4 flavors of homemade cookies.
Honestly, the environment, like, this is such a unique spot. Working here in, like, this little outdoor area and having a space where you can see the sunset when you're working, and there's so much, like, outdoor area for little kids and dogs to roam around. Definitely the fact that we make everything ourselves. It's all small batch out in San Diego where our flagship store is, and we get it delivered every single morning. So all of the ingredients and mix-ins that you'll find in our flavors and the flavors themselves, we actually make ourselves. So it's all handmade, it's all pretty unique, and our head chef gets a lot of flavor inspiration from, like, Asia and Eastern Asia especially, because he's Thai, and so that plays a huge role in the uniqueness of our flavors.
All right, that's it for this story, Coyotes. This was Sahar Bahraini and Sammy Skinner sending it back to the anchors.
Hey, Piper, have you been to North Carolina before?
No, I actually haven't, but I'd love to go.
Well, lucky for you, we got an amazing view of North Carolina from inside a helicopter.
Great, let's see it.
Hey, Coyotes. Over Thanksgiving break, my dad and I took a helicopter tour in Asheville, North Carolina at a place called Scenic. See you in the skies. Scenic has a variety of merchandise such as t-shirts, hoodies, mugs, and toy bears with their logo. They also have a variety of different planes that you can fly on, such as private jets, helicopters, aircrafts, and many more. I'd recommend Scenic as a fun place to go over the holidays if you're in or near Asheville, North Carolina. You can find it at 240 Wright Brothers Way, Fletcher, NC 28732. Also, their operating hours are 9 through 5 throughout the week. Well, that was a long journey, but now that we landed, I'll send it all the way back to the anchors.
Wow, that was an amazing view from there.
Yeah, you could really see what North Carolina looks like.
Speaking of looking at different places, we got a look at Yosemite National Park.
Let's check it out.
Hey, Coyotes. A little while ago, I had the opportunity to go up to one of our national parks, Yosemite.
The drive from Carlsbad to Yosemite is about 8 hours and can be quite the journey, so we stayed at a hotel before getting to the park the next day. But first, we had the chance to go on a hike at the Mariposa Grove of Giant Sequoias. The area was full of massive trees, including the Grizzly Giant. This tree is famous for being almost as tall as the Statue of Liberty and its pedestal. The hike was maybe 2 miles and completely flat the whole way, making it a beautiful experience that anyone can do. The drive out of the grove and into Yosemite was about 1 hour, but we eventually made it to the tunnel and got to see Yosemite's most famous point, Tunnel View, where you can see El Capitan and Half Dome. At this moment, Half Dome was covered in mist, but it still looked just as breathtakingly gorgeous as ever. We later got to our hotel, Rush Creek Lodge, where there was a nice view from the balcony and a roaring fire waiting for us. The next day, we went on another hike at the beautiful Hetch Hetchy Dam, where we walked through a tunnel and were greeted by stunning views of the lake. We walked 2.5 miles to the waterfall, and we got to get close enough to feel the spray. We turned back around and had a picnic overlooking the whole area, walking around 5 miles in total before driving all over the park and stopping to take pictures. On day 3, we went on a brutal hike called Mist Trail. It was 3 miles straight up to the top of a waterfall. You start off the trail at the bottom of the hill and work your way up to the stairs until you get to the top, which overlooks the mountains. Before heading back down, we relaxed next to Emerald Lake.
We walked the other 3 miles back down and spent the rest of the days drinking hot cocoa and playing trivia in the hotel. On our final day, we walked around Yosemite Valley and took lots of pictures before leaving the park to a vibrant sunrise. Now sending it back to the anchors.
Well, Yosemite really is a beautiful place to go.
Now, to end the show, here are some announcements. There's going to be a ping pong tournament on December 18th through the 22nd. Sign up on a Google form.
Watch for an email from Spirit Week, December 18th through 22.
Winter Games, December 18th through the 19th at lunch. Well, that's it for this week, Coyotes. Bye.
Bye.
It's Winter Grand.